How often do you use digital technology today? Today's world seems to have been taken over by digital technology. Me and my brother Benjamin are going to go back to the beginning of the digital revolution to see where it all began. Startling truths will be revealed as we uncover the negative and positive effects of the digital age. Could our obsession with digital technology lead to the end of humanity? So, Benjamin, have you heard of a little thing called the internet? Benjamin?
Oh, I'm sorry, I was checking my Facebook page.
So I got a challenge for you. How long do you think you can pretend it's the 70s and use absolutely no digital technology? Say, a week?
Piece of cake.
You think so?
Yeah.
Well, you realize that means no YouTube, no computer, no cell phones, no Mario Kart Double Dash, nothing.
Yeah, I can do it.
Oh, can you?
Yeah. And let's make this interesting. If I can't go a week without all this stuff, then you can straighten my hair and send me to school in a ponytail.
Okay.
And when I win, I get to post the picture of you from when you were 5.
Which one?
You know, the Helga.
Okay. We won't make any bets. I just want to see how long you can go without your digital war.
Well, in the meantime, let's learn about the history of the digital revolution. Digital is a code expressed in discrete numerical form that helps computers and electronics work. Perhaps the digital revolution all started in the 1300s when the abacus was invented. It doesn't have a microchip like a modern-day calculator, but the fact that it could do calculations for us without having to do it in our heads probably inspired the inventions of the digital revolution. Inventions such as the printing press also inspired people to invent things that do the work for us. By the 1960s, many military organizations were using computers. By the 1980s, many businesses were dependent on using computers. Many jobs by the late 1980s required you to know how to use a computer. Speaking of being dependent on computers, it's been one day since I challenged Benjamin to a week of no digital technology. Let's see how he's doing.
Oh, Benjamin, what are you doing?
I'm calling my friend.
See, this is a digital phone. Let me show you what you need to use.
Damien, you left your calculator over here.
No, Benjamin, this is a Bell telephone. This is what they used before digital telephones.
Okay, so how do you text with it?
Why don't you just make a call?
Okay. Okay, where are the buttons?
No, Benjamin, see, here's how you do it. Pick up the receiver. Now, let's say you want to dial 410. Put your finger on the 4, wind it back. Put your finger on the 1, wind it back. Put your finger on the 0, wind it back. See, it's called a rotary dial.
Who'd you call? Who'd you call, you stupid? Oh, hey, Maria. Hey, yeah. Oh, no, I wasn't talking to you. No. Hello?
If it's one invention that's changed society, it's the internet. In 1980, a software consultant named Tim Berners-Lee wanted to find an easier way to keep track of all of his notes. He created a software that would allow him to access everything on his computer through random links. It was called Inquire. That's when he got the idea. What if you could link information on many computers all over the world? It wasn't until December of 1990 when he finally created the first web browser and server. His friends never expected it to go anywhere. Well, let's just say it kinda did.
What is internet anyway?
Allison, can you explain what internet is?
Just
it came in really handy during the quake. A lot of people, that's how they were communicating out to tell family and loved ones they were okay because all the phone lines were down.
Did you hear that? The internet created a way for people to communicate without the use of phone lines, which is very helpful during natural disasters.
I don't know what she looks like. We've been sending love letters back and forth through the singles bulletin board on the computer.
So when are you going to meet her?
Never. She's 25.
3 days since I challenged Benjamin to no computer. Let's see if he's alive.
1, 2, 3. I got no YouTube, no
amp you're using is digital, right?
It's safe to say that the digital revolution was a turning point in history. It left many positive and negative impacts on modern society. One huge negative effect is online predators. One out of every five U.S. teenagers who are on the internet regularly have received unwanted sexual solicitation via the web. In January 2011, Egypt was looking to overthrow their corrupt leader, Hosni Mubarak, for abuse of power and premeditated murder. Jillian York of Harvard's Berkman Center for Internet and Society said, "The internet has simply afforded people a way to make sure that their voices will not be silenced." Protests spread rapidly throughout the country. Many young protesters looked to the internet and social media to speak their minds. Just before the Egyptian government shut down the internet for Egyptians, Wael Ghanim created a Facebook page to protest against Egypt's abusive leader. The Egyptian government learned the hard way: the internet cannot be stopped. Hosni Mubarak was overthrown. Well, it's been 5 days without digital technology for Benjamin. Hey, Benjamin!
Oh, hey, Damien. I'm using an analog amp now.
Good. You like music?
Yeah, I love music.
You like Led Zeppelin?
I love Led Zeppelin.
Well, want to listen to their legendary untitled fourth album with me?
Ooh, that is a big CD.
Another great thing about the digital revolution is that instead of having to carry around a bunch of records and cassettes, you can store all of your favorite movies and songs on your computer or your small, easy-to-carry iPod. 6 days without digital technology for Benjamin. I'm starting to get concerned about him.
It's okay, Benjamin. It's okay. It's one more day, Benjamin. You can do it. It's one more day, Benjamin. It's okay, Benjamin. You can do it. You can do it.
You okay?
I sure hope so, Damien.
Breathe. Breathe. Okay. Smoke test it. Smoke. Smell it. Okay.
Here's a question. Why don't you go a week without any digital technology?
I did last week.
What was I doing when all this was going on?
But all this information raises a question. Are we modern humans becoming too reliant and dependent on digital technology?
Yep.
Have you noticed that modern day factories are controlled by robots? With an increase in digital technology, many factories are now using robots instead of humans. This is putting many Americans out of work. Could people become so poor that it will end humanity? Probably not. Only time will tell. But in the meantime, people will keep texting and tweeting and Facebooking and doing everything else with their digital devices. Speaking of digital devices, it's been a week, and I gotta say, I'm pretty impressed with Benjamin.
Alright, Benjamin, I gotta admit, I was wrong. You could spend a week without computer. Hey, wait. What's this? You weren't gonna post this picture of me to Facebook, were you?
No.
Okay, but I'm taking this with me, just in case.
Ew.
How long do you think you can pretend it's the 70s and there's absolute, and use absolutely
sorry. You can,
straighten my hair.
And
like, let's say you want to dial 4-
Damien.